Hey guys, myself Mohammad Shahrukh and I'm from BE Mechanical second year. Today I'm going to explain you about brakes and types of belt drives. Now let us start first with the brakes. Brake is a mechanical component which is used to reduce the speed as well as stop the motion of the vehicle, etc. Generally it is used in automobiles such as two-wheelers, three-wheelers and truck, buses, etc. Now, classification of brakes. Classification of brakes. Generally, the brakes are classified into two categories. Generally, the brakes are classified into two categories, that is first one is shoe brake and the next one is band brake. Again shoe brake is divided into two parts, that is external shoe brake and internal shoe brake. Here band brake is also divided into two types, that is band brake and here band brake only. Now, internal shoe brake is categorized into three types, that is mechanical, second one is hydraulic and third one is pneumatic. And here band brake is of two types, that is simple and differential. Now let me explain you the internal expansion shoe brake. Figure shows the mechanical brake used in automobiles. This braking system is generally used for parking brakes. It consists of two brake shoes which are mounted inside the brake drum. This is outer part is called brake drum. These shoes are pivoted at their shell. A cam is mounted here. A cam is mounted between the two shoes. It is connected through the brake pedal by mechanical linkage. The brake liners are mounted inside the brake drum. These are the brake liners which is mounted inside the brake drum and riveted spring mounted inside the brake drum. A brake pedal is pressed. When the brake pedal is pressed and the mechanical linkage rotated, the cam, that is applied the force on the toes of the brake shoes. The brake shoes go away. When the brake pedal is pressed, the cam is rotated. As the cam is rotated, these brake shoes go away from each other. The liners pass against the brake drum and the brake is applied. As the brake pedal is released, the cam rotates by its initial position and the riveted spring bring the brake shoes back to its original position and taking force is released. Here this is the cam and this is the riveted spring and this is the trailing shoes, brake linings, Here this is the shaft and this outer part is brake drum. Now bell drives. When the power is transmitted from one shaft to another shaft, it can be transmitted by using belt ropes, chains and gears. Each method has its own advantages and applications. The belt rope and chain drives are flexible connections. They are useful for when the power is to be transmitted between the shaft, when the distance is considerable by large and in gear it's not possible. Here the different types of belts. This is flat belt, V belt, rope belt and multi grooved pulleys. Now let me explain you one by one. First is types of belts. Here the first one is flat belt. Flat belt, and the diagram is this is the diagram of flat belt. Flat belt. It has rectangular cross section area. It is used in flour mill, factories and workshops. Now the second one is V belt. The diagram of V belt is like this. This is the V belt diagram. It has trapezoidal cross section area as shown in the figure. It is used in automobiles. And working to transmit large power through braille distance, smaller distance. Next, third one is rope belt. The diagram of rope drive is like this. This is the rope belt drive. It is used in lift cranes. And factories to transmit large power. It has circular cross-sectional area. Now first one is open belt drive. Let me draw the diagram of open belt drive. This is the driven pulley. And this is driver pulley. And this is the open belt. Now second one is cross belt drive. in crossbell drive, this is the driver pulley and this is the driven pulley. Crossbell drive. This is driven and this is driver pulley. This is compound bell drives. This is driver pulley and this is driven pulley. This is also driven pulley. Here it is driver pulley. Now, thank you.